Hi everyone, welcome back. It's time for Barbie Dolls of the Week. So this week we do have some Barbies and we have some more clones. So I'm going to say Attack of the Clones Part 2. You know, I've really been enjoying some of these clones that I'm showing you that I have or have gotten recently. And I've got some more that I'll be showing. So, but I want to start with a book this time, or sort of book, that I just got from Amazon. It's this Barbie, 60 Years of Inspiring Girls and Others, I would add, since 1959. And, you know, I love that motto or tagline, but I just think they should have put inspiring children or kids since 1959. But anyway, that's beside the point. It is a coloring book, and I don't usually get coloring books, but I really thought this was cool. It's got such a historical perspective on Barbie in here, and it shows a lot of different years. 71, here's 73. There's ones from 59. Let's see what else. Here's Barbie, Totally Hair Barbie. For some reason they didn't put the year on that one, but it says BU, Be Original. And there's some that aren't specific dolls. Here's one that's an astronaut, I believe, it looks like. Let's see who else is in here, and then we'll move on. Dream It, Do It, I like that one. I really like the large drawings, 1961. This is so cool. So I think they sell this. Oh, here's some. I just noticed one of my favorites, Day to Night. So anyway, I really liked it. It's $5.99, I think, or $5.95 if you get it separately. But I got it. Let me set this over here on one of the piles. I got it with this little kit that has all kinds of art supplies, that's got colored pencils. These are hard to open, though, I will say that. They're a little hard to open, but not too bad. Let me open this, and hopefully nothing falls out. And just so I show you some of the supplies. So this is all the stuff it comes with for the extra $3. So this was $8.95 versus $5.95 for the book alone. So I thought it was well worth it, but I just wanted to show you guys that real quick before we move on to the dolls themselves. So, okay, first of all, as far as Barbies this week, I want to show you this Midge doll. That's Barbie and the Beat is what I'm told she's from that group. These are earrings, so they're pretty distinctive. So I think that's what helped identify her easily. Now, this is not the dress she came in. This is a dress that I had and wanted to try her in. And actually, I do like that on her. It's a little poofy, so she could be pregnant, Midge. But if you just cinch it, it looks better as far as less poof. And I love that little skirt. It is a one-piece, by the way. So I don't know for sure if this is an actual Barbie dress, but I do think so. I put these orange shoes with it. What do you guys think? I think they look okay. It's hard to match orange shoes with something. So yeah, I think she's pretty. I had done some work on her hair. It's very soft now and puffy, as you can see. I think I did the boil method on her, but I don't remember. But anyway, she looks good. Here's a close-up on her face. Okay, now moving on to... This is a Teresa doll, so doing Barbie Friends today, plus the clones. So this is a really pretty Teresa in this beautiful yellow dress. It's one of my favorite dresses I have that's kind of simple and basic, but it's just beautiful. And really, it has an elegance to it, I think. Now, she has very long hair, as some of you really like the really long hair. And, you know, I was wondering which doll this was, because there's not too many Teresas that have such long hair. So I did some looking and also asked, and I actually found her before anyone had responded. She's Cool Clips Teresa, I believe. And Cool Clips Teresa was confirmed by someone online, so that is who we have here, I guess. Obviously, I bought her secondhand, and I redid her hair using the boil method and a lot of cream rinse and conditioning, I mean, and just force, you know, going through matted hair. I don't remember what how bad it was, but anyway, it looks pretty good now. So yeah, this is Cool Clips Teresa. Okay, now on to today's clones. I have three dolls to show you, three different lines, all in the box. And I don't know if they're all going to stay in the box, but yeah, for now, they're in the box. So we, first of all, from the Maxi line, I don't know how many of you guys collect Maxi, maybe. I never did, and I don't really have a strong desire. Here's some pictures on the back. I mean, I'm good with what I collect. I have enough. I don't need a lot of separate dolls. But I really liked this male doll, which is named Rob, as you can see at the top. I wonder if because Ken is three letters and very simple, they wanted a three-letter, very simple to pronounce, and that's where Rob came from. But I'm just guessing. So Rob is Maxie's friend or boyfriend, I'm not sure which. It says, free friendship bracelet, sunglasses change color in the sun. Oh, that's kind of interesting. So, yeah, there's a bracelet in there for the little kid. 12.5-inch posable doll with bending knees, color-changing sunglasses, swim trunks, and bracelet. And each doll, of course, is sold separately. So, I think they might be boyfriend and girlfriend because they're holding hands. But yeah, if you look at his face, I really like the face on the doll. And yes, it does have molded hair. He's kind of burly, too, you know. I mean, stocky, whatever you want to call it, muscular, all of the above. So yeah, this is Rob. He was originally, I think that says 448 at Hills. Says other places 597, but our discount price 448. So as far as a time frame, it's 1989 on the box date. So, you know, late 80s. Okay, so that's Rob from the Maxi collection. Oh, one other quick thing I wanted to show you is I found in my, with some of my loose clothing for Barbie, this little device, for lack of a better word. I think it's a tape recorder, but I'm not really sure. Walkman, I don't know. It's just hard to tell what that's supposed to be. Does anyone know for sure what this is? I'm not even sure what set it came with. Okay, just asking. Okay, then moving on to the next clone doll. This is Sasa Style from Tatsy. So they had a whole collection here of posable fashion dolls, movable head and arms, bendable legs, twistable waist, and it says collect all fashion styles. And there's some really nice looks here, and the dolls are really pretty, I think. So that's why I wanted this. It was a pretty good price. I bought it with another Barbie, an actual Barbie. That was Christmas Barbie. I'll probably sell that one. Not a holiday Barbie, but one of the Christmas Barbies, actual ones. So yeah, this is this one. And there are, looks like, six total in this set. Sasa Style Hip Fashions. It is 11.5 inches. And this is, of course, made in China. I didn't see a date on this at all, so I'm not sure when this is from. Unless I'm missing it, I've looked all over this box, don't see a date. But here's a closer look at her, and she's got the plastic blue earrings, here's her top, and a yellow skirt, that's kind of pretty. She's got kind of a medium skin tone. I don't know, to me she definitely looks a bit Hispanic. So, I'm not just saying that from the word salsa style, but just her look. If you look at her, I believe she's supposed to be Hispanic. But, you know, I've always liked the darker skin dolls, so, and the brunette dolls, so this was appealing to me. And if you look at these pictures, they definitely look Hispanic or even light-skinned African-American, possibly. But anyway, with that name, that's why it makes me think as well. Okay, and then the last doll for the day, and this one I'm going to be taking out of the box to show you better, is was originally sold at Kmart. I can't see the price tag, but she is Aerobic Sandy. and also sold by Tootsie. So Tootsie must have sold a lot of dolls. Does anyone know much about that company? I honestly wasn't familiar with it until very recently. So if anybody can tell me more about it, I would certainly appreciate that education. So here is Sandy, and she does have a Walkman, which reminds me of the one I showed you last week with the Craig doll, the sporty Craig doll. She's got interesting, I think it's almost like Princess Leia looking hair, with a kind of severe split, part in the middle of her